will flatline cardiologists and force patients to visit the hospital for tests they now have done at the doctor's office.
You know, my chances of making it without Medicare is impossible.
As a Medicare patient, Nancy Malo is concerned about Medicare funding reductions that go into effect January 1st, 2010.
And I don't think that there's enough people that know what is going on, the truth of it.
To spread the word, cardiologists across the state held a rally at Lake Eola. Doctors say the Medicare reductions would significantly cut the reimbursement cardiologists receive for offering diagnostic tests like echocardiograms and stress tests. As a result, some doctors will stop offering those tests altogether, forcing patients to go to the hospital for testing.
And hospitals give great service, but they're constrained by emergencies, for example. And so an emergent patient is going to bump a routine patient every time.
At the hospital, doctors say patients will have to wait longer for care and pay more in copays.
I can't even afford the medical copays now. What am I going to have to do to turn around and hit those copays later?
Even though some cardiologists may go out of business because of the Medicare reductions, doctors insist that's not the main reason they oppose the cuts. They fear for their patients.
They're the ones that are going to not get the care, not have access to care, come in sicker, okay, and then they're going to be spending a week in the hospital rather than an overnight stay because we opened up their artery.
Doctors say their message is nonpartisan, and they say no matter what happens with health care reform in Washington, these cuts will go into effect. They are two separate things.